Hello, welcome. Thank you all so much for joining me here. My name is Charity and this message is for Aries. So today we're going to be doing a bonus reading for the month of November, and we're just going to take a quick peek at how the person on your mind is feeling about you right now. So we're going to look into what they're thinking, feeling, hopes for the connection, and what they're likely to do next. So I am recording this message for the rest of November, but I ask these readings to be timeless and have what you need when you need to hear it. The way these cards are trying to fly out right now, someone, oh my gosh, look at that. Aries, it's the Ace of Cups. Someone is definitely falling for Aries. Or fallen. Could be already in and you don't even know it. I'm feeling spontaneity, surprise, excitement, and a little bit of nerves. So what they're thinking overall is the Ace of Cups. What are they feeling? What are they feeling about Aries, Spirit? What are they feeling about Aries? What do they like best about Aries? Oh my gosh. What do they like best about the connection? What are they like least about the connection? Kind of unusual there because it's a very positive card. So we'll pull a clarifier on that. What are their highest hopes? Oh my gosh, Aries, what is going on? You've got Major Arcana. And what are their deepest fears? What are their deepest fears? Spirit, what are their deepest fears? Mm-hmm. And what? I'm going to go ahead and take three cards, just lay them out here to the side, face down. What is likely to happen, what they're likely to do, and what advice there is for you, Aries. It's too many. There we go. Okay. We will see those together. At the bottom is a Wheel of Fortune. Exciting energy, movement, travel, seeing someone. Sagittarius season could be looking really good towards the end of November. But the Wheel of Fortune is Major Arcana, and it's when the universe comes in and takes a hand. If there has been something that has been taking its time or not working really well, the universe is going to come in and kind of shift gears, spin the wheel, and make some things happen. That's really exciting energy. So what your person is thinking about you is the Ace of Cups, and this just jumped out. I mean, you could be newly falling for someone, or someone that you know could be realizing how much they care about you, that they're falling in love with you, or they could just be starting something up with the Ace of Cups. They could be coming in and giving you a bit of a surprise offer because the energy just sort of jumped out there. And it's almost like, maybe we're talking, maybe we're friends. For some of you, maybe you've been on and off again. Maybe this is a challenging connection. Maybe you're in separation. It's going to be different for every single person here. But something just happened all of a sudden. It's like the lights just clicked on. And it's like, wait, I have feelings for Aries. I need to see them. I need to talk to them. Like it just, out of nowhere, it just, I don't know if they heard a song, if they saw your picture, if you put up something new or different on social media. I mean, obviously it's going to be different for every single person because I'm connecting in with so many different people's energies. But whatever the case is, there was just like an aha moment with your person. And now something is changing, something is shifting. It's like they have to tell you that they're feeling the Ace of Cups. What they're feeling about you is the Star. Beautiful energy of someone who has been through some sort of challenge. Something threw them for a loop. Something was challenging to this person because the Star comes right after the Tower. Could have been something between the two of you, something difficult, some sort of challenge, disagreement, miscommunication, or it could have been something else in their life. But whatever the case is, this person is healing. They're recovering. And they can't stop thinking about you. It's the Star. It's a wish card. Like, these are beautiful cards. I'm really excited about this because I never know when I sit down for a reading what we're going to get. And with the star, it's like you are just glowing. Like they are seeing you in such a bright light. I feel like you could have been really realizing some things about yourself. The amazing thing about these kinds of readings, when you're in a connection, we tend to have mirroring energies. We tend to draw in people that, you know, have certain aspects that reflect what we're feeling. And I feel like your person is awakening. They're healing. There's something that they're going through that is very transformational for them, and it could be just the same for you. But this is the star. Aquarius energy, Scorpio, Cancer, Pisces with the Ace of Cups. Seven of Cups. We have Scorpio energy and what they like best about you. I mean, when I see this card come up and it's surrounded by so many positive cards, it's like fantasizing, dreaming, thinking about you, thinking about being with you. Somebody could be having some very, very intimate and very romantic thoughts about you, Aries, with that Seven of Cups being what they like most about you. I feel like you also just bring some variety into their life and interest. And it's like they don't always know what you're going to do or what you're going to say. There's a certain amount of spontaneity that you bring into this person's life, but they like it. They like it a lot. The challenge is, I don't think they really know how you feel or if you've made up your mind about them. It's like they're hoping that you're feeling for them what they're feeling for you, but they're not really sure. There's a little confusion, but it's almost like they like all these feelings. They like being confused by their feelings because it's exciting to feel this much. So it's kind of an interesting take, but it's every single one of these is connected to what is around it. And it's next to the Justice and under the star. So it's like someone who's doing some healing, someone who is hoping you feel the way about them that they feel about you. You could be dreaming about one another. You could be singing similar numbers, times. You could be hearing a song on the radio at the same time, even though you're far apart and you're just thinking about one another. So Spirit, why do we have the Seven of Cups for what they like best about Aries? Why do we have the Seven of Cups here for what they like best? Nine of Pentacles. There's something about you that they just admire. They feel like, it's funny, this is not the traditional card for the Nine of Pentacles. I just tend to know what it is. But they do feel like you have like a certain amount of independence. You've found yourself in a way. You've taken your time. You've done your work on yourself, and they admire that. They admire you. And I don't think you even realize it. Also, if you've recently gotten single or gotten out of a past connection, they're really excited about that and really hopeful and definitely thinking that they might be able to have you all to themselves. Now, obviously, it's not going to be for everyone. We're all in different situations here. But somebody who is in this Nine of Pentacles energy, they're single, they're independent, they know who they are, you know. And I feel like they kind of admire your independence, Aries. And that doesn't surprise me. I'm an Aries. I'm kind of fiercely independent. It's sort of like a theme of my life. I struggle with commitments and connections. I love my independence. But I also love having a partner. I love sharing my life with someone. But in order to have a really good partnership, you have to be in this Nine of Pentacles energy. You have to have your own balance, your own independence. And I think that they've been hoping for a chance to be with you, maybe for quite some time, and now they feel like their chance might be here. So what do they like best about the connection is the Judgment card. There is something about you. This is Major Arcana, and I feel like the two of you are being guided. Like there's something about the two of you being guided together by the universe, by signs, or you know, maybe even like a soulmate energy, because we have a Justice and a Judgment card, and we have another card I'll tell you about in a minute. But there's something very significant about this connection. And there's something about the two of you, like when you met, neither of you have really been the same since. Something has changed. Something has transformed. They're hoping for a more positive future. For some, they're hoping that that something can be resurrected. Obviously not for everyone, but sometimes that's the case with the Judgment card. But I do feel like they They're hoping to put the past in the past and have a new beginning and for things to get smoother and easier if there's been some sort of challenge between the two of you. And I'm going to go ahead and pull a clarifier on that too. Spirit, why do we have the judgment card for what they like best about the connection? Why do we have the judgment card for what they like best about the connection? Oh my gosh, are you kidding me, Aries? Knight of Cups and the Ten of Cups. It's like they're already decided that you're the one, that there could be something here, something lasting, true happiness. Virgo energy with the Nine of Pentacles, but did not mention that. And then we have Scorpio and Pisces for the Ten of Cups and Knight of Cups. Cancer energy can be there as well, but this person feels like they might have a chance. They want to make some sort of romantic gesture. They want to do something. Like, I love this. I love this for your reading. What they like least is the Four of Wands, which is a little confusing because the Four of Wands is a very positive, very exciting card. It's the card of a connection, of a commitment. And maybe there's fears around the fact that, you know, you're so independent or there's some independence that you're not ready for a connection, or maybe there's long distance. Maybe they don't know how to make it work. Spirit, why is the Four of Wands what they like least about the connection? Why is the Four of Wands what they like least? The World. Okay, there could be some sort of long distance. They feel the connection to you with this beautiful red thread that connects the two of you, no matter how far apart you are, no matter what differences you have, no matter what difficulties arise. There's a connection. You can both feel it. You're both aware of it. But they might feel like it's, you know, if there's a distance, or even if it's a, you know, physical or emotional distance, maybe they don't know how to take things to the next level. Maybe they want to have something more fulfilling, more lasting with you, and they're not sure how. The Highest hopes are the Empress. That's the card I was holding that I just like, I couldn't even believe when that came out for the Highest hopes. Taurus, Libra energy could be significant. Aries with the Four of Wands. But they feel like you could be the person. They're incredibly attracted to you. I don't think they've ever felt this way. And it's not just to like, look at you. There's things they like about you, about your style, about your, you know, your attitude, the way that you, I don't know, you just kind of go after what you want. And if you're creative or whatever it is, there's a lot of things that they just like about you, and they feel like there could be potential here. The Empress is unlimited potential. And it's like the feeling of the one. What they like, what their deepest fears are, is justice, which is another incredibly positive card. But the justice is about the law of attraction. It's about what we put out, we get back. And maybe there's been some kind of challenge, and maybe they're afraid that, you know, they've lost the chance, or things are, you know, might not work. Or maybe they, you know, they have feelings for you, and maybe you don't feel the same. Spirit, why do we have the justice card as the deepest fears here? Why do we have the justice card as the deepest fears? Why do we have the Justice card? Eight of Cups. Okay, now we're getting somewhere. Someone has walked away at some point. Maybe you, maybe your person, or maybe somebody is in the process of releasing an old connection, or maybe there's something from the past that's just been kind of, you know, because the Justice card, it can be legal papers, it can be, you know, finalizing something, releasing something, and maybe they're waiting for you to, you know, to know that you're fully free. Maybe they're curious, maybe they're wondering, you know, have you walked away from something? Are you free? But that's just one story. There's many, many that are coming through. And I do feel like with the Eight of Cups, Pisces energy could be significant. Libra with the Justice card. It's quite possible that that someone's walked away from this connection. And it's almost, I don't know, it almost feels a little petty. Like, oh, if, you walked away, or if you're quiet, I'm going to be quiet, or if I'm quiet, you're quiet, you know, like, I don't know. It's almost like they want to come towards you. They want to see you. They want to be with you, but they feel like they have to do whatever you're doing, you know, or you have to do whatever they're doing. So if somebody's being quiet, the other person thinks they have to be quiet, you know, because the justice, it's like this equal energy. And so, you know, someone may have pulled away, and instead of like, pursuing or communicating or saying, hey, you know, I really have feelings for you, I want to be here, it's quite possible they're thinking, oh, well, if Aries, you know, if Aries wants to be independent, if Aries pulled away, maybe I need to, you know, give space or something like that. And it's, like I said, it'll be different for everyone. Take what resonates, leave what doesn't, because something about this feels very specific. But someone's also leaving behind things that have not been fulfilling, because they really are hoping for something more. So, what is likely to happen? Oh my gosh, King of Pentacles, Aries, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn energy. Someone that really does want to make a commitment. So this is the King of Pentacles. I mean, when they show up, they're all in. This is a stable energy of someone that, it's like they want to make you their person, like the person that they're with, the person that they come home to, the person that they just laugh with and spend time with. But with the Knight of Cups, which is a knight, it's an energy, you know, it's not a king. They're showing up here as the King of Pentacles, but they're kind of coming in as the Knight of Cups, wanting to make an offer, maybe not fully sure. But boy, when somebody comes in as the King of Pentacles, this is someone who wants to see it through. So what are they likely to do? The Hermit, Virgo energy. Oh my goodness. So this person, it's all this Knight of Cups, this romantic energy. They feel like you're the Empress. With the Ace of Cups, they're falling, like falling for you. They're hoping for this beautiful Ten of Cups, this Judgment card, like just being together, you choosing them, them choosing you. So why are they going into the Hermit mode? Maybe to make a decision, maybe to think. It's a quiet energy. Why is this person being so quiet? Spirit, why do we have the Hermit card here? Two of Wands. They do want to start something with you. They do want to move forward. And if you're distant, they want to travel towards you. They do want to take action. Aries energy again. They want to make something happen. It's almost as if with the Hermit card and the Two of Wands, it's like they're quietly deciding exactly what action to take towards you. Oh my gosh. Spirit just said, look at the bottom of the deck and look what's on the bottom of the deck. It's the King of Cups. This person is, might be in Hermit mode, might be quiet, might be processing something, might be looking at your pictures, might be feeling like there's some sort of distance, but they're deciding how to make this offer. It's like they're making the decision right now how to come forward as the King of Cups, not this knight that comes in and maybe makes a lot of promises, but doesn't really, you know, stay. This is the King of Cups. Scorpio, Cancer, Pisces energy could be significant. This person is definitely falling for you, Aries. So what is your advice? Two of Swords. Very interesting. And I was wondering if Swords were going to come into this, because I was just thinking, I haven't seen any Gemini, Libra, Aquarius energy, except the star, which was Aquarius. But Gemini energy could be significant. Oh, yeah, we did see the Libra because we had the Justice card. Okay, so I think everything's represented here. I always start to wonder, some things show up really strong, but some things will be, you know, some signs will be different, but like a little quieter. But we do have Gemini showing up here. The Two of Swords, this is when it's time to make a decision from your heart. It's time to get out of your head and into your heart space. I feel like there could be some overthinking going on, especially if your person is having all these feelings, but kind of in hermit mode, making a decision. It's like they've got the Two of Wands, you've got the Two of Swords. It's like you're thinking about one another, wanting to make a move towards one another. But I feel like if you're in this Two of Swords energy, Aries, trying to be logical about it, trying to do the right thing, Spirit is saying, get into your heart. Get into your heart and think about what you like, what you love, what makes you happy about this person, why you're thinking about them right now, why they're on your mind. What do you hope for in the connection? And don't be afraid to hope. Don't be afraid to trust your heart. Spirit, why do we have the Two of Swords? My goodness. We have the Five of Wands, the Ten of Wands, and the Ace of Cups. There could have been some sort of challenge and some sort of difficulty, some sort of conflict or something that either it's you feeling kind of conflicted about what to do or some sort of conflict that happened between this person. But we have a Ten of Wands. It's like you're almost there. You're wrapping up a burdensome cycle of kind of carrying these feelings on your own and feeling like, you know, with this Ten of Wands, like maybe you feel like you have to be the person to reach out. Like you're ending that cycle. You're wrapping that up because this person is coming towards you. And you have an Ace of Cups. Once again, Spirit is saying, get out of your head and trust your heart. Sagittarius energy could be significant. Leo, and then Scorpio, Cancer, Pisces again. Trust your heart. And this whole reading, I can't even believe this, started with an Ace of Cups and ended with an Ace of Cups. It's like the love that the two of you have for one another is going to draw you together. So get into your heart space and focus on that love and just watch magic happen. So that is a message that I have for you for our bonus reading for November. I'm going to be bringing a love message for every sign. So be sure to check your sun, moon, Venus, rising. I find my Mars to be very powerful too for readings. Even your Mercury could be very specific because it's kind of how you communicate. So thank you once again. Thank you all for joining me here. If you'd like the message, I'd love you to put a like. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do. Definitely hit the notifications. And if something spoke to you and you'd like to order a personal reading, I'd love to hear from y'all. I love connecting with you. My website is charitygenise.com. I have tons of options there for readings. And it's been a blast getting to connect with you all, getting to know y'all a little bit better as this channel grows. I appreciate you all so much, and I'll talk to you soon.